Today I am going to start, my dear student, good morning. Today I am going to start uniform circular motion. If a particle moves along a circular path with a constant speed or constant velocity, then the motion described by the object, that is called uniform circular motion. Example, all of you react within the wristwatch. The motion of a hands along a circular path. That is the motion of the tips of the second hands of a clock, of the wristwatch. It is an example of the accelerated motion. In this, first of all, we want to define the angular displacement. Angular displacement. That is the diameter. The angle made by the radius vector. Angle made by the radius vector in a given time interval with the axis of the circle or with the diameter of the circle, that is called angular displacement, and it is denoted by theta. Theta is equal at any instant of time, particle is at point A. At any instant of time, particle is at point B. So angle BOA, that is called angular displacement. That is called angular displacement. Therefore, angular displacement theta is equal to angular displacement theta. Theta is equal to length of the arc to the radius of the arc. All of you know from this one. Length of the arc, suppose it becomes delta S in a small interval of time. And delta and arc. Or we can also write theta is equal to L by R. Both are the same term. There is no any difference between them. That is the length of the arc. Theta is equal to L by R. As a unit of angular displacement, is radian. SI unit of angular displacement is radian. R-A-D. It has no dimension formula, so the dimension formula of angular displacement is equal to M0, L0, E0. Now all of you must be able to understand this one, the angular displacement. All of you know that one also. Angular velocity, the time rate of change of angular displacement, that is called angular velocity. Second point is the angular velocity. It is denoted by omega, not W. Angular velocity, the time rate of change of angular displacement. Rate of change of angular displacement. Angular displacement. That is called angular velocity. It is denoted by omega. Omega is equal to theta by t. We can also write omega is equal to e theta by dt. We can also write omega is equal to 2 pi by t. Omega is equal to 2 pi by t. We can also write omega is equal to 2 pi nu. Since nu is equal to 1 by, that is the relation we can define in the different way. Where we require, there we apply that one formula. Now the time period, the time taken by the particle to complete one revolution. Is going from A to A, that much time taken by the particle, that is called time period. It is denoted by capital T. SI unit of time period is second. SI unit of time period is second. All of you know that one. Frequency, the number of revolution. Number of revolution completed in 1 second, that is called that is called angular frequency, that is called frequency, and that one frequency is equal to reciprocal of time period, reciprocal of time period. Assignment of frequency is Hall. Assignment of frequency is Hall. HET RZ or per second. We can also write per second. So we have the term angular velocity. Time rate of change of angular displacement. We can write omega is equal to theta by t. Omega is equal to d theta by dt. Omega is equal to 2 pi by t. Wherever we require. Omega is equal to 2 pi nu. Omega is equal to 2 pi nu. Because 1 by time period is equal to frequency. Therefore, we write omega is equal to 2 pi nu.
Is it clear? These are the very simple terms. Once you go, then it will be very easy for you. Now the relation between linear velocity and angular velocity. Linear velocity and angular velocity.
V is equal to R omega. All of you know that. V is equal to R omega. Relation between the linear velocity, relation between linear velocity v and angular velocity omega. All of you know that v is equal to r. Let a particle moves along a circular path of center O. Radius is equal to every time. Particle moves with angular velocity omega along the circular path. At any instant of time, particle is at point A. Time t is equal to t. At time t is equal to t plus dt or delta t, particle is located at point B. Particle is located at point B. Therefore, angular displacement. Small angular displacement is equal to delta theta. Length of the arc is equal to delta S.
Length of arc is equal to delta S. Therefore, we can write
that delta T is the small time interval. Small time interval, delta S, small length of arc, OA is equal to radius of arc, circular arc.
Therefore, delta omega is equal to?
Omega is the angular velocity. Omega is the angular velocity. Therefore, omega is equal to delta theta by delta t. We can write. Therefore, delta theta is equal to omega into delta t. Equation number one.
Also, delta theta is equal to delta theta is equal to delta S by
R. Length of arc to the radius. Length of arc to the radius. All of you know. Therefore, also we can write delta theta is equal to length of arc to the radius. Equation number 2. Very simple. Left hand side are equal. Therefore, we write omega into delta t is equal to delta S by R. Now R is taken. R into omega is equal to delta S by delta t. This one is the velocity. Small change in displacement to the small interval of time. That is known as velocity. Therefore, we can write V is equal to V is equal to R omega. We can write in terms of limiting case also. So that delta limit delta is equal to delta t is equal to limit delta delta t is equal to 0. Here there is no any variable, so that can be left out. Ds by dt, rate of change of displacement is known as velocity. Therefore, velocity V is equal to R omega.
We can also say. Now the expression for centripetal acceleration, we can also write in vector form.
Vector B is equal to R cross omega. Vector B is equal to R cross omega in vector form. And this one is the scalar.
Now the centripetal acceleration.
This is very important. Centripetal acceleration. The acceleration is directly towards the center of the upward path. That one acceleration is known as centripetal acceleration. Many important centripetal.
Now we have the various type of example in which the centripetal force comes into play.
Therefore, we can write as
centripetal force directed toward the center of circular path. It is also known as radial acceleration. Radial
acceleration. In some books it is written as radius, radial acceleration. Let a particle move along the circular path, center of radius r. At any instant of time, particle is at point A. If the velocity at point A is equal to v, at time t is equal to t. At any instant of time, particle reaches that point v. At this point, its velocity is equal to v plus delta v. V plus delta v. Subtend an angle delta theta. Therefore, we can write that at any instant of time, t is equal to t plus delta t, particle is at point t.
Because the direction of velocity along the circular path act along the tangent of the circular path. That's why we indicate that one.
Delta theta, small angular displacement. At OA is equal to radius of circular path. If at time t is equal to t, velocity of the particle is equal to v. Velocity v is equal to v plus delta v. This is the velocity. Is equal to v plus delta.
Therefore, now you have seen this one. One is a triangle is for to find the length of the arc, and
this can be obtained from the triangle law of vector addition, so that we can draw this one triangle separately and give the name OAB. Here velocity V plus delta. E plus and third F velocity. So in a triangle law vector addition,
when the two vectors are represented by the two sides of a triangle in magnitude and direction, the resultant vector is represented by the diagonal of the
represented by the front side of a triangle in magnitude and direction taken in opposite order. Then in triangle OAB, OB is equal to OA plus AB. OA plus AB, therefore AB is equal to OB minus OA is equal to B plus delta B minus B is equal to delta B. So length of the arc is equal to delta
V. Length of arc is equal to delta V. Therefore we can write as also we know that delta the omega is equal to delta theta by delta t.
We know that just omega is equal to delta theta by delta. Therefore delta theta is equal to omega into delta.
It. Now just all of you study. So also
a small angular displacement delta theta is equal to length of arc over here. Therefore length of arc is equal to delta V. Why? Compare left hand side are equal, so right hand side also equal. Therefore, we can write as omega into delta t is equal to modulus of delta v by v. Therefore, omega into v is equal to delta v by delta t. We can also write delta v by delta. Now taking the limit both the sides, limit delta t tends to be 0, delta v by delta t is equal to limit delta t tends to be 0, v into omega. Here there is no variable term, so this term can be analyzed. Here limit delta t tends to be 0, delta v by delta t is equal to dv by dt. The time rate of change of velocity is known as acceleration. Therefore acceleration is equal to v into v by r, since v is equal to r omega is equal to v by. Therefore acceleration a is equal to v square by that acceleration is directed to what?
The center of circular path is known as centripetal acceleration. The acceleration is directed toward the center of circular path. It is known as centripetal acceleration or radial acceleration. It also acts towards the radius
of the circular path. So that is also sometimes known as radial acceleration.
So that therefore centripetal acceleration
is equal to v square by r. You can also write r omega square. V is equal to r omega. V square is equal to r square omega square. Therefore, AC is equal to r square omega square by r. One r cancel out. Therefore, AC is equal to r omega square. That is also the centripetal acceleration. It is directed toward the center of circular path. Is it clear? Now, third one, angular velocity. I will come on centripetal force. Angular acceleration, prime rate of change of angular velocity.
That is called angular acceleration.
Angular acceleration is denoted by angular acceleration. Time rate of change of angular velocity. Alpha is denoted by alpha. Alpha is equal to d omega by dt. Sometimes it is also written as omega by t also. Wherever you require, that one you can find. SI unit radian per second square. Radian per second square. Levinson formula. L0 t minus 2 t minus.
So that we can conclude that one, acceleration, angular acceleration. Now I come to the centripetal force. Come to centripetal. This is a very important point now going on. Centripetal force.
Very, very important. We can every day we apply it to the centripetal force. And in physics also, centripetal force. When centripetal acceleration is multiplied by mass, that is called centripetal force. Force is equal to mass into centripetal acceleration is equal to m into g square by r. M r omega square. These are the various equations we use wherever we require.
Now, application of the centripetal force. Vehicle on a level circular road.
Very important points are now going to start. Vehicle, first one. A point. Vehicle on a circular road. On a circular road. Let a vehicle of mass m move along with circular path of radius. The force due to weight acting the downward direction. Reaction acting the upward direction. One is the force due to friction comes into play. Which act between the tire and rod and directed towards the center of circular path.
So this force of friction provide necessary centripetal force to move the vehicle on a circular road
or arc. There are following forces. The important is a car of mass m moving on a circular road of radius. That's all. In all you have to write. there are following forces. Pala, force due to weight. Force due to weight. Reaction R. Normal reaction. Normal reaction. Tisra, force of friction. C point. Very important point is the force of friction. Force of friction. This force of friction comes between the tire and the road. Between tire and the road. Therefore, the force of friction provides the necessary centripetal force to move a vehicle on a curved circular. Therefore, force of friction provides the necessary centripetal force to move a vehicle on a curved circular. Also, we know that force of friction is equal to law of friction. Force of friction is equal to mu into R. That means the coefficient of friction between the tire and the road. R is equal to m into g. Therefore, F is equal to mu mg. Equation number 2. This is equation number 1. From equation 1 and 2, right hand side also equal. Therefore, mg square by R. Mg square by R is equal to mu and mu to g. M and cancel out. Therefore, g is equal to root under mu r. Mu r g. Where mu is the coefficient of friction between the tire and the road. So that the car can negotiate the flat circular road with the maximum speed v is equal to root under mu r g. Is it clear? So that if the vehicle is moving more than this one, v is equal to root under mu r g, then what will you do? Then we have to do something. This one, the force of friction between the tire and road, is not a real level force. ये भी कोई विश्वासी आदमी नहीं है, ठीक है? Then the force of friction is not sufficient to provide the necessary centripetal force to move the vehicle on a circular road. If the speed is more than mu rg, then the car must be skid up from the road and accident will occur. Is it? That's why we can raise the outer edge of the road slightly or little as compared to inner edge, and that one is known as banking of road. And the phenomenon of raising the outer edge little to the inner edge is known as banking of road. Banking of road is necessary because need of the banking. We know that the speed of car is excess, then root under b is equal to root under mu rg. Root under mu rg. The force of friction is not sufficient to provide the necessary centripetal force to overcome this one problem. The outer edge of the road is slightly raised as compared to inner edge. It is known as banking of road. Is it clear why it is necessary? Now, the inner edge is slightly raised as compared to outer edge. Now, we draw the diagram when force of friction is not taken into account. We have derived this one, the safe speed and optimum speed, the motion of a vehicle on a banked circular road, that is called banking of road. first point. In a day is slightly less as compared after age is slightly less as compared to energy. As compared to energy. The vital mood on the control, the force into make reaction are now dissolve the reaction into the two components. One is the R cos theta, another one is the R sine theta. The component of force, R sin theta, component of force will provide the necessary centrifugal force to move the vehicle on a bank road safely. Therefore, there are various forces. First one is the force due to weight, second one is the normal weight. Resolve R into two components, one is the R cos theta, another one is the R sin. R cos theta balance the weight of the vehicle or car. R sin theta provide the necessary centrifugal force to move the vehicle on a banked circular road. Therefore MD is equal to R cos theta. MD square by R is equal to R sin theta. This is equation number 1. Then equation number 2, dividing 2 by 1, we get MD square by R into MD is equal to R sin theta by R cos, R sin theta by R cos. MM cancel out, therefore D square by RD is equal to tan theta. Therefore, B is equal to root under R into B into N. This is the safety speed of a car to negotiate a bank circular road of radius R. It is the safety speed of a car or a vehicle to negotiate a bank circular road when no force of friction is taken into account. Is it clear? Now I discuss the when the force of friction is taken into account and that force of friction comes into play. Is it?